All right, guys, the Dean89 back here again. I've got another drone review. Drones have not really been my thing. I do all kinds of stuff to, you know, putting floors in my camper, to, you know, riding dirt bikes, to playing hockey, doing all kinds of stuff. But I saw the drone, the Sky Viper FPV 2400 HD got me into this. It's a slippery slope, so now I've moved up. So the Hubsan H501S X4 is about to be unboxed here. I'm about to show you. We'll do the unboxing. I'll fly it around for a while, let you guys see that, and then I'll just do an overall review of what I think of the product. I have very high hopes for this thing. Seeing all the research I've done on drones, I've watched hundreds of videos on drones already from YouTube. And I've kind of narrowed it down to my price range. I'm not trying to, unless I'm generating income from this thing, I'm not trying to spend more than, you know, $300. I think I spent $265 on this thing. But like I said, unless I'm generating income from it, I'm not going to spend $800 to $1,000 just to take great pictures. I want something that's fun to fly, takes decent videos, and I can go high, high enough, you know, 400 feet FAA. You know, legal limit, I endorse that. So without further ado, let's go ahead and crack this baby open. And I may or may have not got this from, you know, your friend Amazon.com. Big fan of that company. Big fan. It's great. Wish it was around, you know, when I was growing up. We're gonna go ahead and open this bad boy up. Show you what we got inside. Some nice Amazon bubble wrap there. Alright. Wow, that's actually a lot smaller than I thought it would be. This is it. Alright, so on the box, you can kind of see, you know, what you're getting exactly. You're getting the X4 FPV brushless drone with HD camera, GPS, automatic home return. Let's hope it works better than the V2900. Altitude hold and really cool follow me. It's a Hubsan. Says ages 14 plus on it. I've got the black version here. There's two versions. You've got the black and you've got the white. I want the black because with the previous drone that I had, the Sky Viper V2900, you could see it in the sky, or in the sky, a heck of a lot easier than you could a white drone. So let's go ahead and crack this baby open, and let's see what kind of contents we are getting inside here. All right. Point towards you since you are the audience here. All right. So you got... kind of cool packaging, you know, like the college that I went to, they had a packaging major, and I never knew what, you know, that really entailed. But this is kind of cool, the way they, you know, stuff in there and make it fit, and there's actually things in here. So let's go ahead and pop this open. Let's see what this is. I have no idea what it is. All right, looks like the charger. All right, you get the charger. Just standard DC wall charger. All right. You also get the, I don't even know what the heck this is. Hubsan balance charger. All right. If I'm not mistaken, I don't know. I'm going to have to get back to you on this. I have no idea what that is. Yeah, I'm going to do a review after I fly it. I'm pretty sure I'll be able to tell you what everything is. All right, you open this other cool little box here. Looks like the extra blades are in here, the props. Oh yeah, they definitely are. You get 8 of them, 4 to put on the quadcopter, and 4 extras. All right, and these are big. They're nice. You can tell they're nice plastic, quality. They can run into some things, and you'll be all right. But you get 8 of them. All right. Next thing we have here is the I'm going to open it up to see what it is. All right. Oh, okay. I know. I think I know what this is. This is a sunshield cover for the remote. I'll install it. I'll show you guys what it looks like. So when you're holding the remote, you can kind of, you know, the sun doesn't get you as much. All right, the quadcopter itself. Man, this thing's got some weight to it. You know, since I had that V2900 by Sky Viper, you know, this is probably a little bit more heavy. But this is just a cool looking quadcopter. You get the brushless motors. It's just a cool looking thing, you know. You can see the battery pack looks like it's about the same as the Sky Viper, but it looks a little bit more easily accessible. It's just, it looks like a car, you know, a future car with some kind of props on it. But let's go ahead and let's try and pop this thing open and see what kind of ease I get. Oh, so much more easier than Sky Vipers. Don't need a coin, clearly. All right. That is really, really nice. So you have a LiPo 7.4 2700 milliamp battery in here. All right, that comes right out, and that was shipped in it. It's got two connections on it, all right? Two completely different connections. One is to hook up to the quadcopter itself. And the other one looks like it's to charge it. You guys can kind of see that. Yeah, this thing is pretty cool looking. I am actually very, very excited to fly this. And see what she should provide for us. Just based on the reviews, I'm expecting a lot. You do have your SD card reader right on the side there. I'm expecting to get some pretty decent video, but this is a little bit heavier. Like the Sky Viper 2400 that I have, can just bounce it off stuff. I don't think this one's gonna take it as much. But last but not least, we'll go ahead and we will crack open the remote. Packaging again, flawless. And this remote is actually a heck of a lot larger than I thought it was. What is this? That's the handle. Good job. This thing's a lot bigger than I thought. Holy crap. This thing's pretty big. Doesn't look big on the video, but you can see I'm 6'2", and this thing's the size of my chest. It's a lot bigger than I thought it was, actually. But it, you know, it's impressive. Looks good. We'll hit more on that in a minute. Looks like you've got your brushless manual. And this thing is just packaged so cool. I mean, there's just like every little compartment. Now they got me checking all the boxes to make sure that there's nothing in them. And it looks like there's nothing in them. all right, so yeah, this going back, this came out as well. This is the tool. All right, when you need to put on the quadcopter's props, you're able to hold the rotating brushless motor base and screw those right on. No big deal. This is actually nice. This is like rubber, all right? This is like not just cheap plastic. Kind of tell, you know, it's not making the plastic noise. It's actually just rubber. So that means you're gonna get some good grip on solid surfaces. That's actually pretty nice. Oh man, back to this thing. Holy crap. This thing is massive. I'm just going to go ahead and kind of install this just by looking at it. So bear with me here. You know, maybe I won't install this. This looks a little complicated, but I'll keep talking. I'll keep messing with this. But this thing's huge. I can't get over how big, you know, I expected this. I didn't expect how big this controller was. But Hubsan, you know, for not knowing much about their company, I can tell that this is a quality product. I can just tell, you know, this, they did not, you know, go short with the quadcopter at all. And it tells you that by the new model. I guess there was an advanced model I didn't even know about. I was out at work and I decided, I was like, hey, I'm going to buy this thing. You know, I'm working hard. Things are going well at work. I'm going to treat myself. I'm going to buy the hubs I've been looking at. Well, I did not know that there was a advanced version. The only way I was able to tell that is by the remote itself. So after I had already purchased it, I realized, you know, there was an advanced. And I was like, oh, damn, you know, I spent, you know, $267 on this. And the advance was, geez, another $100. So I'm actually pretty happy. I've seen some mods that you can do to this remote for under $10, and it looks really easy. I am not a tech guy, but I do have a power drill, and I am able to watch YouTube videos. So therefore, I should be able to do that mod as well. But you know, so far, this isn't bad. You know, you've got your sun cover here, and this just snaps on here, so the thing looks like it fully closes in, which is pretty cool. We'll see how bright the screen is. May or may not have to do that. I'll show you guys that in part of the flight review that I do. But the unboxing, pretty impressed. You know. Pretty impressed, pretty happy with what I've got here. Looks like they also have the hookup here to use four AA's. And I know these things fly through AA's. If you've got a screen going here and you've got two antennas pushing out, you're about to burn up some AA's pretty quick. So what I do see is the connection for a LiPo battery of some sort. It won't fit this one, but I know that there are conversion kits that you can buy online for relatively cheap. What I plan to do is keep this drone, fly it. If I like it, I'm gonna invest in it. I'll do the antenna swap. I will do the battery extension because I think this is about as far as I'm gonna go with drones. It is a slippery slope. I, you know, I started out with $140 drone, went back to the $100 drone, went up to the $175, $250 range. Now I'm here and I spent about $270 on this off of Amazon. And, you know, for a hobby, you know, something that I just like to do, you know, go out and fly this stuff, I think this is where I'm going to end. Just because once I go past this, I'm looking at the up airs, you know, that gets you into the mid 300s, you know, low 400s. I'm looking at DJI Phantom 3s that get me from 5 to 600. Then I'm looking at, you know, DJI Phantom 4s, and I'm over $1,000 before I know it. I wouldn't say that I'm hurting for money, but I wouldn't say that I'm well off, and I cannot justify spending over $1,000, or let alone, you know, over $400 on a drone if I'm not generating some kind of income. But this I think is gonna cure the itch that I have for drones. Been curious about them for a long time, mainly with FPV. I wanted to put goggles on, I wanted a drone on the ground, and I want it to fly up, and I want to feel like I'm flying. I think that would be, you know, pretty cool. I think that's it for the unboxing. Let's go ahead and give this thing a flight, and let's see what she has for you. All right, guys, I'm back here again. Got a different beer, drinking Shop Top Ginger Wheat. Wouldn't recommend it, not that great of a beer. I apologize for going back and forth, but I, you know, finished last video and I, you know, was like, hey man, I'm going to put this together and maybe get a hover in the garage. Put it together, I was like, wow, this thing has some pretty cool lights. Just make sure that you're putting it together correctly. You know, might take a try or two. And then you gotta kinda just shove everything, all the guts. Yeah, hello. You gotta shove all these guts, you know, back into it. There's plenty of room there. You know, Hubsan did an alright job. And the best part is, man, just being able to click that shut. That V2900 Sky Viper that I had, super pain in my butt. You can watch that video. I'll put the link here if you haven't, and get my opinion on that. But this thing has some LEDs that are absolutely no joke at all. Now, it's 10 o'clock at night. I'm not going to fly it right now, but I eventually will fly it at night. We'll give it a try. Just because the LEDs are so intense.
All right, guys, back again here to do the flight review as promised. All right, let's go ahead and spin this up. I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit more thorough job on this review here, this flight test. So I'm going to go ahead and just plug it in here. All right. Should hear it beeping. Lights are on. I'm going to shove all the guts back in there. All right. I'll go ahead and we'll turn on the TX here. You gotta wait for the satellites, of course. I'm tracking zero right now. All right, so it's on, LEDs are going. You gotta calibrate the compass every time. So what I do is I just go like this, calibrate it and turn it. It's like clockwise, twice. Maybe I'm going the wrong way here. So, go like this. Still telling me it's not calibrated. Maybe it's because I am on some metal, and I was. All right, so now we're gonna turn it downwards, and we're gonna twist it this way. All right, so compass is calibrated. Had a little hiccup there, my bad. All right, so still tracking no GPSs right now, but this thing I've got a lot of high hopes for this. Pretty excited. So just reading through the manual last night, the trims on off, follow me mode, you press down, GPS, your photo, your video, and your return to home. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and mark a return to home station here. Hopefully the dog doesn't move it, but we'll have it that bone right there, and we'll do a return to home test as soon as we take off. And if I get away from the house a little bit, I might be able to get some satellites. So we'll set her down here and wait on these satellites. I've got a full battery. If you can see the readings here, screen's looking pretty nice. It's a little shaky. It seems to be already be coming in and out. But we've got six GPSs or six satellites on the drone GPS. We've got zero on the remote. I'm going to wait till I get a few on the remote there, and then we'll send it. It should pop up. All right, I've got seven satellites on the GPS here, or the on the drone itself. All right. Let's go ahead and send it. So we're going down and out to power it up. And then we're gonna keep it in GPS mode. Go on, Whiskey, go on. All right, we'll send it up. Oh, wow. That is, that's impressive. It is not even moving. That is a great hover. That is nothing like the last drones that I've had. The thing is completely stagnant. It's not moving at all. Now let's go ahead and we'll start this video up. It says it's recording. See what kind of height we can get here. Get a pan. Still, again, not moving at all. That is pretty cool. Wow. Now I've got 12 satellites on the drone itself, and I've got five on the remote. This is incredible. This GPS hold is Unbelievable. I'm at 21 meters right now. Then we'll bring it up some more. Now I'm purely using the TX, just because it's so high up there. And it is not moving at all. That is pretty incredible. I don't know if you can see here on the remote itself. Not too fuzzy. We're sitting at 46 meters. Again, we'll get a pan of the neighborhood there. It's pretty high up. That is impressive. There's a school. Still directly over my yard, which is pretty cool. I'll send it up a little bit more. Alright, we are now at 70 meters and video's kind of cutting in and out. But then we'll do a pan. And it looks like my video turned off. Nope, still recording. That is pretty cool, guys. Let's go ahead and let's bring it down so we can see it. I'm just holding the joystick down and it comes down at a very controlled rate. So the thing does by no means just drop out of the sky. Sounds like a swarm of bees. But there she is. She's coming down. Yeah, I am so far extremely impressed. Extremely impressed. I'm afraid to take this GPS hold off. But let's go ahead and let's hit that return to home. The bone over here is marked it. All right, so we'll go ahead and we'll try this return to home. I just flipped the switch. Let's see how close it gets to that bone. Wow. All right, so that wasn't too bad. I took off with about 7 satellites, and we're looking at about, I don't know, 2 meters here. So return to home is off. Let's go ahead and let's send it again. Let me adjust this camera down just a little bit for you guys. Sorry about the shakiness. All right, let's send it. Let's see what kind of distance we can get. Turn it home is off. We'll bring it back up. We'll go for a little flight over by the bushes there. Trees. Yeah, as soon as you let off on the throttle there, it just stops right in place. I don't know if you can see on the remote here. But yeah, that is pretty cool. I'm really impressed with that. The control is good. Doesn't fly very fast. That is about full throttle right there. But again, I'm on GPS mode right now. But it is just pretty cool, man. This thing is smooth. You know what? I feel really safe flying this. Unlike the other ones I flew, I feel actually very safe flying this thing, because it is just so smooth. I'll go ahead and take a picture in flight. That thing is just not moving, man. That is really cool. Wow, I am impressed. So just keep flying around here. Can do the we'll try the follow me mode and we'll see what we've got going with that. Might be pretty interesting. Got rather a small area here, but we'll go ahead and we'll hit the down button on the remote here. All right, so I've hit the down button and we'll just start walking away and see what happens. It's following me. It's still following. You know what? It's not really facing me though. That's interesting. But it is following me. That is pretty cool. Still walking back. Still following. That is pretty cool. Impressive. So again, we'll turn that off. We'll just go up again. Show you what I can see here. Took about 2.5 hours to charge. 2.5 hours to charge. Looks like I'm on about 10 minutes of flight time right now, actually. So we'll see how long this thing lasts. Pretty curious. It's reading that it's got 1 out of 4 battery bars left. Not sure if you guys can see that. Not sure, you know, if this is just like the other ones, not very accurate. But let's go ahead and let's send it up again. Let's get a recording of it sending up. And we'll kind of just get a good view of this thing going up. All right, we're gonna send it up. Here we go. Video's a little shaky. What that thing, man, it is going. It is gone. Video's shaking. I'm at 61 meters right now. So just a little over 100 feet or so. It's reacting a little slow. That's kind of scary. Might be because the battery is getting really low on the remote. But we'll go ahead and we'll send it up a little bit more. We're at 77 meters now. Oh, 102. Just because of the lack of battery power, I'm going to bring it down just a little bit. Getting kind of nervous. I've got one bar on both the TX and both the drone itself, but she's still reacting. Well, yeah, we'll bring her down just a tad bit more. She wasn't reacting for a minute. It kind of scared me. Thing is up there and it is not moving. Yeah, there we go. Now we're getting her back. You know, and that's how comfortable I feel with this thing. First flight, and I'm already kind of pushing limits here. But I feel so comfortable flying this thing with the GPS hold. It is just really cool. I am impressed. For $250, this was a great buy. This video quality looks pretty good. I'm pretty excited to see what it actually looks like off the SD card. Again, we'll stop that video. What I think I'd like to do now for you guys is actually, and again, I'm not doing anything right now. Whoop, accidentally hit the record button. I am not doing anything right now. I mean, the controller's there. It is just doing its own thing, and that is really cool. I'm gonna go ahead and take the GPS mode off. GPS hold off, and I'll let you guys know what that is like. So it is off. Now she's starting to drift with the wind a little bit. As you can see, she's kind of going away. But let's see, you know, a little bit faster, not a whole bit, not a whole lot faster, but wow. Okay, so this is different. This is news to me. This thing is like floating, like it's on ice. If I hit back and let it go, it's just gonna drift. It is not like GPS mode. That seems to me kind of dangerous, because if you get a lot of momentum and you've got to stop real quick, you're gonna run into stuff. But
all right, guys, so all in all, if I had to condense this 30 minute video into the next 60 seconds, I would say buy this drone. This thing is awesome. No ands, ifs, or buts about it. The GPS hold, seriously good. The height, the distance, the FPV, fantastic. You can fly this thing, you know, 200 meters,
no issues at all. Distance, I only got up to about 120 meters in height, and I was getting a little static, but I'm definitely going to do that conversion kit. I'm definitely going to do the battery pack install, which you can find on YouTube. Drone is worth it. You know, I am so pleased with this thing. It is no joke. I tried flying it in the garage just for a hover. Crashed it, cracked a few blades. This thing is not a toy. I'm about to register it with FAA right now. Not a toy, though. Treat it, you know, with respect. Otherwise, you're going to get some consequences that you're not prepared for, like I did. Like, the blades literally put holes in my wall, in my garage. Things pretty intense. Overall, Hubsan H501S, great drone. You will not be disappointed for the amount of money that you're going to spend on it. Give her a try. Absolutely. All right, so if you liked the video, thumbs up. If you didn't like it, thumbs down. Give comments. Tell me what I can do better. I'm just trying to give you guys information that you need before you spend some money on this drone. Again, the Dean 89, thank you for watching.